Everyone, and welcome to part 2 of the Final Fight playthrough. And before we begin, I would like to offer my condolences to the family and friends of civil rights leader Nelson Mandela. He, as you probably know, he passed away yesterday at the time of this recording. It was the same day I'm uploading it, but this civil rights activist essentially serves as Africa's Martin Luther King, I believe. And he helped pave the way for a more democratic future for his family and friends in Africa, as well as spreading a message of peace throughout the world in his life. Anyway, well, what can I say, but we lost a true warrior for peace. We will miss him too. Anyway, getting on to the episode. You take control of Guy in the band stage. Guy's actually essentially what I've probably said before, but I will repeat again for reasons. He does a wall kick. And he smashed. He dashed with some kind of punch combination and a kick. I would suggest using him if you're surrounded. Because Cody's a bit slow and Hagar is pretty much even worse than Cody. You won't get hit edgewise if you're using Hagar in a crowd. Anyway, I believe Andori strangles us and throws us into his cage or two other members of Andori. Either way, we got plenty of weapons to do so it's fine, I guess. Sometimes they can double team you, so you need to be careful with that. Like I said, Guy is the best for crowds. Especially the knife book guys, because it's kind of easier for him to dodge. Come to our boss, Eddie, I believe it's pronounced. Anyway, you can pick up that gum and besides the folks they have to deal with, you'll have to deal with True Tattoo, the boss here. You'll have to deal with him beating you with the baton. And later down the fight, he'll take out his gun and shoot you. Using the timer for jumps when that happens. That's what you do. Here we come into the industrial area. Watch out for the color of the flame that pop up pretty free. Not only can those flames hurt you, but it can hurt you. It can hurt the opposition, so use a near beam. This guy's gonna be pretty tough to handle if you don't really watch their behavior, because they not only ram into you with they not only ram into you like that, well, lions, but they also tend to kick you from up close. So be careful. We get to the elevator section. I don't think this is the first elevator section ever, but I think this is the best known elevator section. Anyway, Mooks will just jump down and attack, along with some weapons occasionally. Thank you. essentially throws... He essentially throws bombs. So... Watch out for the little gray, pellets that you drop, because those are really grenades to make it explode and deal massive damage. I would hate that... I would hate Guy in this fight because... Let's face it, he's faster and he's more likely to hit you. Even when he gets to half health, when he gets to half normal life bar, now he basically spazzes out all the shots. And throws bombs everywhere. And when he loses, he blows himself up. Anyway, before we go, I'd like to give a shout out to W2F Gamers. I am a loyal subscriber to them, or at least I try to be. They are in turn, well, they are in turn one to me. They do, I believe FIFA and I believe. Do they do Minecraft? I'm not sure. Kind of forgot. Do they do, FIFA? Yeah, they do FIFA. Anyway. They also do Band of Beasts. I think it's 1-4 there. That's why I do special. I believe they have around 50 subs, I need to check, but anyway, if, random hijinks and, FIFA are your thing, you might want to check them out. And they also do Minecraft, I believe. Anyway, SilentProd17, signing off for,